Hi, it wasn't my intention to make this into a series, but something happened this morning which I thought I would share with you because it had me thinking a little bit about some of the ways that we interpret concepts and words to do with our identity and the way that we interact with the world and how we define that will have an enormous impact on how we behave and how we interact with the rest of life. So even if, for example, we don't consider ourselves to be a god, if we consider ourselves to be either allied with a god or in possession of enough knowledge and wisdom to consider ourselves godlike in relation to the rest of life, then we set ourselves up in a very particular way that limits us, I think. But what happened, and it's just a little story really, was that this morning I went into the greenhouse and there was a little young chaffinch in there, which must have flown in through the open window. I've got a window that kind of opens and closes itself depending on the temperature, and it was throwing itself at the glass. And of course, it's all glass in a greenhouse, so it was just flying about, utterly confused. So birds don't seem to be able to perceive glass unless you have something stuck on the glass, which makes it very clear that there's something there, which I've now done in the French window, and they don't fly into it anymore. I've put a bird, silhouette of a bird on it. But in a greenhouse, of course, that's not possible. And it was panicky, you know, and there the little mouths are open and wild-eyed. And I knew that I needed to get it out of there, that I couldn't just leave it to find its way out, because the opening wasn't big enough. Even if I opened the door, which I did, and kind of, you know, I opened the door and said this way, and of course it didn't go out the door. So I had absolutely no choice but to manhandle it, to let it, set it free. And I knew also that there was a risk that it would have so much shock that it would die anyway. But it was going to, if I didn't get it out of there, it was going to die. It would have died of heat, of nothing else, or battering itself against the glass. So I put my hand to hold it, and or to have it perch on my hand. And you could see in its face that it wanted to do that, that there was this kind of dichotomy of instinct towards terror of this vast creature that seemed to be lumbering about and trying to get it, and some kind of sense of safety and trust in that huge creature that it wanted to help it. And it got onto my hand. And I wasn't kind of enclosing it. I should have tried to enclose it, but I didn't really get the chance. And moved it a little way, and then it kind of was sitting there, and then it sort of launched itself off too soon. And so I did it again, and it climbed on my hand. And I managed to get it close enough to the door just by moving my hand with it perched on it that it could get out of the door. And I was thinking that I am like God to this creature, or like its worst nightmare, because it doesn't know whether I'm there to help it or kill it. I doesn't know whether it needs to move towards me or away from me. And as humans, I think we have such an influence over life on this planet. You know, we don't have complete power because we aren't gods, though we might like to think we are. But we have a massive amount of influence, and we are to some creatures God in that we give them life and we take life away for our own ends, which is not particularly godly as far as I'm aware. Perhaps the other end of the spectrum. But you may be able to hear a fly buzzing about at this time of year here. I don't know about where you are. Life is just going berserk. There's life everywhere. All the plants are going wild in growth, and all the baby creatures are bursting into life, and there's insects all over the place. You know, daily I'm having to kind of get flying things out of the house. And I would be fascinated to be in the mind of another creature as to how humans are perceived, often with loathing, I suspect, or terror. I saw a thing recently on bonobos. I know that, you know, well, they are our closest relative, and they have more empathy than we do in experiments. They will show far greater empathy and desire to help others, even to their own detriment, than we would. You know, we could learn quite a lot from them, as I suspect we probably could from other apes. So we are in this very bizarre position, and I just thought I would share those few thoughts with you. And again, you know, what do you think about our tendency to promote ourselves to gods or to be like gods too much of the life on this planet?